Hello students, welcome back. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. In this session, we will study pure peer-to-peer architecture. In networking, we know there are two types of architecture. One is called as a client-server architecture. Second one is a peer-to-peer architecture. Actually, client-server architecture depends on the server and infrastructure. But in peer-to-peer architecture, there is a minimal reliance on always on infrastructure servers. There is a minimal reliance on infrastructure servers. Instead, here the arbitrary end systems directly communicates, and those end systems are called as peers. And these peers are intermittently connected and change IP addresses. The example for peer-to-peer architecture is file distribution by using BitTorrent, streaming, and voice over IP, that is Skype. These are the applications or examples for a peer-to-peer architecture. So in this session, we will see file distribution by using peer-to-peer architecture. Actually, we will consider peer-to-peer by considering a very natural application, namely distributing a large file from a single server to large number of hosts called as peers. In client-server distribution, the server must send the copy of the file to each of the peers, placing a burden on the server and consuming larger amount of server bandwidth. But in peer-to-peer file distribution, each peer can redistribute any portion of the file it has received to the any number of peers, thereby assisting the servers in the distribution process. We will now consider a simple quantitative model for distributing a file to fixed set of peers for both architecture types, that is client server architecture as well as a peer to peer architecture. Now in the illustrated diagram, you can see here is client server architecture with the server and peers, n number of peers are there. We have a file of size f bits need to be transmitted from the server to the other peers by using client server technology. Now the question is, how much time to distribute a file of size f from one server to n peers? Now for simplification, we will take u suffix s as the upload link of the server access link, upload rate of the server access link, u1 u2 u3 u4 and u suffix n are the upload rate of client access link. Similarly, d suffix 1, d suffix 2, d suffix I, all these are the client download rate. So we have n clients here and we have a server with the file of size f bits. So if you use the client server technology to transfer file from the server to the n clients, then distribution time for the client server is, server should transmit the file sequentially, say should send the file to n number of clients, that is server has to send n file copies to send one copy to the particular client. The time taken is this one. To send n copies, the time taken is this one. Now if you take dmin is the minimum client download rate, then minimum client download time, that the client which is having the least amount of download rate will take more time, and the minimum client download time is this one, then the time to distribute a file f of size f bits to n clients using client server approach is the maximum of these two parameters. So if we consider the same thing with the peer-to-peer architecture, then in the peer-to-peer architecture, server must upload at least one copy of the file. After that, client has aggregate work to download the NF bits. So now here you see time to send one copy of the file is this one. And as discussed earlier, minimum client download time is F by D minimum. So the aggregate, when the client works as aggregate to download NF bits, the maximum upload rate is summation of UI, that is the individual upload rate of each client, and server access link upload rate. So now time to distribute a file to n clients using peer-to-peer approach is, this is the expression. So maximum of three parameters. First one is F by US, F by dmin, and this one. So here you can see the comparison of client-server versus peer-to-peer. The minimum time distribution time versus number of clients or number of peers. And in client-server technology, the distribution time increases linearly with the number of clients or number of peers. But in case of peer-to-peer architecture, after some time, after certain number of clients, then the minimum distribution time remains same as the n, the value of n increases. So this, in this way, this is the advantage of peer-to-peer file distribution or client-server. Now we'll see here one of the important protocol for our peer-to-peer file distribution is a BitTorrent. So the collection of all the peers participating. Now we'll see the application of a peer-to-peer file distribution, that is a BitTorrent. The collection of all peers participating in a distribution of a particular file is called as a torrent. Peers in the torrent download equal size chunks of the file from one another. Typically, the chunk size is 256 KB. So, peers in the torrent send and receive files, file chunks. So, there is a one infrastructure node called as a tracker, which will keep the track of all the which will keep the tracks of all the files, all the peers joining the torrent or all the peers leaving the torrent. So let me repeat, torrent is nothing but a group of peers exchanging chunks of files. Now when the user, particular user Alice arrives, when Alice joins the group, or when Alice joins the group called torrent, she obtains a list of peers from the tracker. Tracker will give a list of peers or list of neighbors to the Alice. Alice will successfully obtain or successfully makes TCP connection with all these neighbors and begins exchanging file chunks with the peers in the torrent. Now, peer joining torrent has actually no chunks or no data, but will accumulate them over the time from the other peers. First, the peer joins the torrent, register with the tracker to get the list of peers and connect to all those peers, and those peers are called as neighbors. While downloading, peer uploads the chunks to the other peers also. Peer may change peers with the whom it exchange chunks. Peers may come and go, and this is called a churn. One peer has an entire file, it may leave or remain in the group. At any given time, different peers have a different subsets of file chunks. In our case, Alice asks each peer to for the list of chunks that they have. So for this, Alice will use one technique that is called as rarest first. Alice sends chunks to those four. See, after that, depending on the rate of data the Alice going to receive from the neighbors, Alice sends chunks to those four peers. They are currently sending her chunks at highest rate, and others peers are chalked by Alice. That means others peers don't receive chunks from Alice. So every 30 seconds randomly Alice select another peer and start sending chunks, and those peers which Alice is sending chunks is called as optimistically unchoked, and other peers are called as choked. So in this diagram, Alice optimistically unchoke Bob, and she will send the data at highest rate to the Bob. So Alice becomes one of the Bob's top four providers. Similarly, Bob becomes one of the Alice top four providers. In this way, data will be uploaded from one peer to the data will be transmitted from one peer to the other peer in BitTorrent. So the next topic is distributed hash table. So here we'll consider how to implement a simple database in peer-to-peer network. We know how the simple database is stored in a centralized version, that is client-server network. In the client-server network, it will store the value something like key and value pairs in the simple database. For example, key is a human name and value is a social security number. You can see here. So, key is a movie title and value is IP address of the machine where the particular title is stored. So, the more convenient way to store and search on the search for the key is by means of hash value. So, in the hash technology, we are taking the hash value of the original key and it will assign that to the key. So, building a simple straightforward database with the client-server architecture that is stores all the key value pairs in one central server is very easy. But in peer-to-peer version of the database, the database is stored over millions of peers. In peer-to-peer system, each peer will only hold a small subset of the totality of the key. So, such type of database design is known as a distributed hash table. Here, any peer can query database with the key. Database returns the value of the key. To resolve the query, small number of messages exchanged among the peers. Each peer only knows about small number of other peers. Now, to assign key value pairs to the peers, first we need to assign ID to the peers. For example, if we take the ID space is like this, and suppose there are 8 peers with ID 1, 12, 13, 25, 32, 40, 48, 60. Now, the rule is, suppose if the key is 51, then that is assigned to peer with ID 60. That is, assign key value pair to the peer that has the closest ID. If the key is 60, then same that is assigned to peer 60. If the key is 61, then it is assigned to peer 1. Like this, it is assigned. So, all the peers normally organized, all the peers are organized in a circular arrangement. As shown in the diagram, each peer only keeps tracks of its immediate successor and immediate predecessor. So, in the diagram, you can see here, all the peers are arranged in a circular arrangement. This circular arrangement of the peers is a special case of overlay network. This circular arrangement of the peers is a special case of overlay network. In overlay network, the peers form an abstract logical network which resides over the underlying computer network consisting of physical links, routers, etc. All the peers will resolve the query. You can see, suppose the peer want to know the value of the value associated with the key 53. Then it will send the query to the next peer. Similarly, the query moves from one peer to the other peer till it reaches destination, and destination will send the value. But this method takes complexity of this method is something like big O n messages on average to resolve query when there is n number of peers. In this circular DHT, we have additional architecture with the shortcuts. You can see here what is the value for the key 53. That is, peer 12 wants to know the value associated with the key 53. So now, peer will get this value with the shortcut methods as shown here. So, your total attempts is reduced from 6 to 3 messages. Now, handling peer in this circular DHT is one of the big tremendous work. Peers may come and go, and that is called as churn. Each peer knows the address of its two successors. Each peer periodically pings its two successors to check the aliveness. If immediate successor leaves, choose the next successor as the new immediate successor. For example, in the diagram, like peer 5 leaves suddenly. Now, peer detects peer 5's departure and makes 8 as immediate successor, and it will ask 8 to know who is the immediate successor of 8 so that it can make a note of peer 4 can make a note of immediate successor and the its second successor. So, in this way, DHT, that is distributed hash table, works. Thank you.